That's how Mrs. Corazon is. Sometimes she gets very depressed. But come the next day, it'll be as if nothing happened.
Oh? You know, I noticed something at their house. Nothing but pictures of Jesse. Where are the pictures of the daughter that they lost?
They were taken down by Jesse and Mr. Marshall. Oh. They hid away everything that would remind them of Arabella. That's why Aunt is keeping herself busy with all those restaurants of hers so she doesn't remember the pain and sadness. Hold on. Let me just take this. Hello? Huh? Okay, wait there, I'm on my way.
Oh, are you all right?
My mother, her eyes moved.
Ethan! Mother's finally conscious.
Who's with her there?
Miss Gui. Come on. Oh.
Come on. Hi, Gui. Thank you.
Hi, Aunt.
Mother? Mother? Can you hear me over there? Claire told me her eyes opened earlier. Mother, are you finally waking up?
Ethan.
Hmm?
Is this the first time this has happened?
Ever since she lost consciousness? Yeah. She hasn't moved since.
Her vital signs look good.
Ever since Dad got that case, she's been depressed. Then after he killed himself. There. Mother got even worse. She stayed in bed for so many months. She never stopped crying. Then she got a stroke. Then she fell into a coma. She's been that way for 15 years, and we've been taking care of her for that long. So there. All the money she saved up with my father are all gone now.
I see you're still sleeping here, huh?
Yeah. Sometimes, here. Other times, I sleep beside my mother. You see, I wanted it so that when she wakes up, I would be the first one she sees. I really miss my mother. I do. Especially the way she takes care of us. You know what? Don't tell anyone, but I think my mother's cooking is a lot better than Aunt Corazon's. Nothing beats home cooking. Right, Claire?
Is that so?
That's why I really hope she wakes up, so she can finally meet you.
We've been trying to contact you for days. Why weren't you answering?
I'm really sorry, Pa. Things have been busy at the hospital right now. We have so many patients. So, I never get to check my phone.
Do we have a problem, Reed?
Pa?
I really hope we don't. I just want to know something. Are you falling in love with Ethan?
What? And who would spread rumors like that?
Why did you stop me from shooting Ethan then?
Why do you want to kill Ethan?
Because we almost got caught.
But we didn't get caught, did we?
I know you, Rhea.
Well, we need Ethan alive because it's our mission.
I know that look in your eye. Ever since we were children. You love that soldier boy, don't you?
So you think you're a psychic now? Have you tried applying for a
what
job?
Under?
You made a good fortune
teller. Why don't you two shut up over there?
Pa.
Rian. You are not allowed to fall for that soldier. He is our enemy. Remember that. He works for the one that ruined our lives. He is the one who killed your brother. Do you understand?
Yes, Pa.
Keep this in mind, Brienne. Don't you ever forget just who your enemies and allies are. And just to make sure, let me tell you this now. Just me. The one who truly loves you is just me. No one else.
How well do you really know that Rian?
Of course not as much as you know her. You're the intel officer. Why?
No reason. It's just that I feel something different about her. She's such a fake. She makes my blood boil.
I know exactly how you feel. You don't have to tell me.
So you feel the exact way about her as I do, right?
Every second of the day, I think the word for it is jealousy. That's exactly what you're feeling. Jesse?
I'm done talking
Jesse.
To you!
Miss Beautiful, I was joking! Jesse!
Yourself, then go walk to the kitchen, right? Don't get me started because I'm not in the mood and I'm tired. You got that?
You know, Mrs. Amelia really has it out for her because she's the reason why their eldest son died.
How's that possible? Wasn't she still a toddler when the military killed her brother?
I've heard the story behind that even back in the day. They said she was a really naughty kid. When the soldiers were after them, they were actually about to escape them. But then she ran off. Her brother had to look for her, and then there, the poor boy got killed.
I love you, Ma. But do you love me too? I hope you can forgive me one day. I never wanted my brother to die. I never wanted to hurt you either. I love you so much, Ma. If I could turn back time, then I should have died instead of him.
Let me guess. You're thinking of Rian? I hope you haven't forgotten about our child. Our real child. Santi, not Rian.
You don't have to remind me. I'm not some kind of senile old man, you know? Someone just needs to show Rian that someone still loves her. Because otherwise, she might disobey me and the day might come when she turns on me like a dirty traitor. And please, Amelia, can you just stop being so jealous of her? Who knows? What if someone hears you? And all those years we worked hard for will be for nothing. We're hiding a huge secret about Rian's identity that everyone must not know. What would you want for that to be a waste?
I know all about the plan. I'm just worried that you're getting too close to Rian.
What kind of nonsense are you blabbering about now, huh?
You're not pretending that you love her anymore. Your feelings are becoming real. Why? Is it because you see her mother in her?
I think you're the one who's getting senile here. How am I going to win over the girl's loyalty if I treat her instead like some wet rag, just like how you obviously...
Because she makes me feel like I'm competing with Corazon, even though she's not there because I'm faced with her daughter. Go ahead, tell me that I'm wrong.
Sure, I'll tell you. You're wrong. You are dead wrong, Amelia. Because I'm preparing her for a much bigger war. And that is for when she finally kills her very own father. There, Amelia. That is the most painful thing that can happen to a parent. That's the most painful thing that will happen to Marshall.
Please put it there, Nanny. Dad, why did you have to invite your illegitimate daughter to come here?
That's right, Pa. After 20 years, she'll just show up as if nothing happened. Come on, Pa.
This is my birthday, and you said I can invite whoever I want.
Amelia, there you are. Have you been waiting there?
Yes, I was waiting here. In fact, I heard every little thing you said about me. Oh, Sylvia, relax. I won't take your inheritance, because my husband is richer than you. Dindi? I wouldn't be here if Papa didn't invite me.
Amelia.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday, Papa.
Where's your husband?
Busy.
Busy with what?
Enough, Sylvia.
Papa, I'm here to wish you a happy birthday.
Thank you. I'm happy that you came here. Ah, Amelia, why don't you congratulate Dindi? She has been promoted to vice president of their accounting firm.
I'd rather you congratulate our brother. He's the CEO of JV Pharmaceuticals.
I didn't know that.
Well, I was hoping I could surprise you.
Wait, really? I feel like I should buy stocks of your company now.
Yeah, our shares are 13% higher this month. You should consider.
And what about you, Amelia? What's new with you? Tell us, does your husband have any new illegal businesses?
Sylvia! Aren't any of you going to sing me happy birthday?
I'll just go get some candles.
Well, how are you all here?
We're all doing really good, General. Thank you for asking.
Okay. Hey there. There you go. You be extra careful with that. It might spill all over. And we don't want that. It's worth a lot.
Yes, General.
The same goes for you. You see these? You be very careful and make sure that these boxes are sealed tight, okay?
Yes, General.
You see that? It spilled all over. When that happens, just be... Oh, I thought you were over at your dad's birthday party. Don't tell me it finished. It's so early and you're already here.
My siblings still haven't changed a single bit. They're still as arrogant as ever.
Do you want to have some fun? We could just blow up all their houses. Or maybe plant some drugs on them. I didn't become the head of a group of terrorists as well as drug pushers just to have my wife be disrespected. You know what? Maybe you should all go. Take a break right now. Go on. So when you get back here, you'll be a lot more productive, okay?
Go on, take a break. Finish that later.
Jules.
Yes, sir.
Jaime, go with our people here.
Yes,
feed them
yes,
something.
Yes, General. Come on.
Once you're done eating, head back here, all right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Come on, let's go. Come on.
Really? You're fine with dirtying your name over something as petty as that? Why not just let them keep suspecting David Pascal instead?
Amelia, even if they wanted to, they can't just arrest me so easily. I have way too many connections and plenty of money. Here, you see this? See what I'm holding here? Besides, we're already using David Pascal as our puppet. So they have even less reason to suspect me for anything.
Shh. Just take it easy. Fine, if they piss me off, I'll let you know.
You're such a drama queen.
By the way, about that daughter of yours, have you spoken to her? Did you ask her if she's really fallen in love with that soldier?
She told me that she didn't, and I feel like I can believe her.
You really trust Rian, don't you?
I was the one who raised her, so I know her very well, okay?
What if it's true?
It's not that hard to have Ethan killed, you know? Done. Like that. So relax. See you.
Rian!
Santi? Now I'm all wet. Have you been good while I was gone?
Of course I have.
Really now.
Oh, Rian, have you eaten yet? We have snacks. Oh, let me just get a plate and fork for you.
Rian, I have a new toy robot. It was from Papa. Wait right there and I'll show you.
All right. Draw yourself first. All right, show me your new toy.
Hey, be careful. You might slip. Here you go, Rian.
Thank you. Where's Mama and Papa?
They're at the mansion. They had me and Santi come home first, along with Mrs. Gloria.
You mean they're not coming here?
I don't know. Maybe they're both still busy. I'm sure they'll be here later.
Do you remember if I had a teddy bear?
Teddy bear? You barely had time to play. And I don't remember. Why?
No reason.
You should eat. Here.
General. There's something you need to see.
Its total worth was estimated to be over 500 million. We're offering a reward of 1 million. To anyone who will give us details concerning the leader of this smuggling syndicate.
And we have enough evidence that will prove that these people are connected to a powerful international terrorist group. We, together with other government agencies, are offering a reward of 1 million to the one who can lead us to the leader of this terrorist group. We will do everything within our power to stop this group's activities before they can ruin any more of our countrymen's lives.
Sir, what will you do with the confiscated drugs?
According to Pidea, all of these illegal drugs will be burned so that no one can use them and no more lives will be ruined by them.
Idiot! What do you mean by 500 million? Huh? Those were worth 1 billion! 1 billion! That's a lot! Why did you burn them? And above all, those were all mine! Mm-hmm.
What are your plans, General? We're losing so much money.
And all of my investors are still waiting.
Can you still handle this?
Just a small glitch in operations, but this happens every now and then with our missions. And I can still fix that, so just calm down, okay?
1 million is a lot for a reward. What if someone rats us out?
There is no one that can betray General Santiago Guerrero.
You better be sure, General. Because if this blows up, we're all on our own. And you will take the fall.
Are you trying to scare me?
I'm just reminding you of what...
Then you might as well make it a threat.
You better make sure.
Well, let's call it a night.
Just like rats deserting a sinking ship.
There's no doubt that Rien is good, General. But the way I see it, with all due respect, General, she's not ready to continue the mission. Give the girl some time to rest. We have plenty of men who are well trained.
But Rien is the most skilled one of them all. She has every single ounce of my trust. Sure, we have plenty of other men. We have Franco. But he's not ready. He is not as ready as Rien.
Sir, what will you do with the confiscated drugs?
According to Pinea, all of these illegal drugs will be burned so that no one can use them.
Have you seen the news?
Will be ruined by them.
That piece of cargo you lost. The enemy burned it all.
I saw it.
You failed again. How are you going to become his right-hand man? There's only one thing I want, Franco. That once Tiago is gone, you will become the next leader of the group, no one else.
I'll become his successor, I'll make sure of that.
Oh, really? Well, what if that woman beats you again? Stop dawdling around, okay? Because the moment Rien outsmarts you again, I'm going to shoot you myself. You haven't changed at all, weakling! Don't forget, Franco. If you're a loser in life, people will never stop walking all over you. So you had better make sure that you will never lose to anyone. Understand?
Expensive that is, right? Didn't I tell all of you to be careful with the merchandise? Do your jobs properly. Pick that up.
I'm sorry, Sir Franco. I didn't mean to.
Hey, get out of here. And don't ever come back. Okay?
Sir, my wife is pregnant. I really need this.
Well, I don't care about that. Hey, listen up. We do not accept any failures and morons around here. This isn't the time to be making mistakes here. You understand?
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes, sir.
Back to work!
Sir, I'm begging you, sir, please. Ma'am Amelia, please. My wife is pregnant, ma'am.
Franco?
Ma'am!
Get out of here.
Ma'am, I'm begging you, please.
Reggie, I'm really sorry, okay? I'm going to try to find another job for you. You know the rules here, Reggie. No one can know this. You know Chaco. Wait here.
Ma'am.
Go ahead and take this.
Ma'am, I can't.
Just take it. Take it before I change my mind. Now go.
Thank you. We're just going to do our rounds.
Yes, Doc.
Rianne? Rianne?
Ma'am? Oh, what brings you here, ma'am? Are you feeling okay?
I came here to see Jesse. And after that, on the way to the car, I kind of felt dizzy, so I figured I should stop by here.
Please, sit down. Here, I'll get your blood pressure. Sure. /140/90, ma'am. It's a bit high.
But I always make sure to drink my meds every day.
Why don't you talk to the doctor, ma'am? Maybe you're just tired from all the cooking you've been doing. Are you preparing for another party?
It's not that. But I did come from the restaurant to take care of some business.
Ma'am, you need to take care of yourself. You're going to make your customers sad that way. Especially me. You know, ma'am, until now I can't forget your cooking. It really is just that good.
Well, tomorrow I'll be at the restaurant again. Don't forget, you told me that you wanted to learn how to cook.
Oh,
when do you want to do that? You want to do it now? When are you off work?
Now's good.
Are you sure? Hey. Don't lift the lid. I'm afraid you cannot take a peek. We have to let it boil for 3 whole hours. And that's when we'll, add the other ingredients. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Please excuse me.
Are you okay?
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. That was so clumsy of me. Sorry.
Oh, let me have that. It's all right. It was an accident.
Are you all right, ma'am?
Yes. This belonged to my daughter.
It's Jessie's?
Oh, no. My eldest daughter with Marshall. It's the reason why I'm so thankful that Jesse came into our lives. Because Marshall and I became parents again.
You know, Jesse's really lucky to have you two as parents. It hurts to lose a parent, but I think it hurts even more to lose a child.
It's not easy. But for the sake of my family, I stay strong. Kind of like you. I'm certain that if your parents were here, they'd be very proud of you.
Ma?
Oh, here in the kitchen. I'm here.
Are you okay?
Yes, I am.
Jesse. Hi.
Oh, you have a guest. Mm-hmm. Who is it?
I went to get a checkup at the hospital, and she was the one who took care of me. And she just got off work. So I asked her to come with me over here, and I'm teaching her how to cook.
Ma, sorry if I didn't get to read your text message right away.
It's okay.
Rianne?
Yes?
We can take care of Mama. You can go home now. We're really sorry. We had plans today.
Love? What now? You think you can still go out?
Of course.
Then let's go.
But I think it would be better to stay here instead. Because Rianne and I already prepared some food for tonight.
Okay, we'll stay here.
Ah, is that so? In that case, I'll be the one to help you, Mama.
Oh, no. I know you have no interest in cooking. You're having dinner with us, right?
Okay, if I'm not going to be a bother to you.
Nonsense. I like having you here.
Thank you for taking care of my wife here.
Oh, sir. It's nothing. I should be the one thanking her. I learned so much today.
Too bad we're not going out.
Traffic? This tastes really good, Rian, dear. Right, Marshall? Jesse? It's good. Thank you, ma'am. It's because I had a good teacher, that's all. Please. Stop flattering me. You're just like Marshall.
Wait a minute. I never did such a thing. Come to think of it, didn't you slip me a love potion before? Back in the day, everything you cooked for me was always so special. Aha, you did slip
did
in
I
something.
Did I really need something like that?
Honestly, until now I still don't know who fell in love with who first. Mama told me it was you, Papa. But Papa told me it was you, Mama.
Well, I was the camp heartthrob. It's true.
How about we both did? How about we both did?
Oh, all right.
Please excuse us, Rian. We're always like this. It's not every day we get to eat together, so we savor every second.
It's okay. It's actually nice to watch.
Hey, Rian, on your day off, why don't we go out sometime?
Ma, don't impose on Rian. You can always just go out with me, right?
But it's difficult with you. It's the same with your dad, too. Even on your days off, they call you in. And of course you're not allowed to refuse the orders of your superiors. So by the end of it, I'm all by myself again. Just like that. Go on, take the
call.
Excuse
me, please. Yes? What? Do we have a taker for that 1 million? Oh, okay.
Jesse, grab some napkins.
No, they're right there. Ma'am, where's your restroom?
First door on your right.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, ma'am. All right. Thank you.
Send some men right away to the factory he told you about. This might be the lead we've been waiting for. I'll follow suit.
Rian, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sorry. Come on, let's go back in.
Okay.
Get ready. Something very important came up. We have to go.
Okay.
Be ready in 5 minutes.
Yes, Pa. Adelina?
Hello?
Pa. Looks like someone decided to rat you out to the military. They're on their way to the factory at Liwanag. You have to get out of there now.
Is that so?
Okay, wait a minute.
And who's the dirty traitor who did it?
I still don't know.
Then find out right now. I want to know who the dirty rat is.
Yes, Pa.
Sir, what about my wife? I have to check on her, sir. My wife is pregnant.
No problem. Don't worry. Tomorrow, head to the safe house.
Del Fierro?
Sir?
Validate the location given by our asset. Assist the asset. Make sure you're discreet about it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, go.
Okay, men, move.
Traitor who did it. And find out right now. I want to know who the dirty rat is.
Oh, Lieutenant Bonifacio.
Hi, sir.
Are you looking for Ethan?
Yes, sir.
They left a while ago.
Oh, is that so? Do you know where they went?
Classified.
It's okay, sir. I understand.
Once he gets back, I'll tell him you dropped by.
Thank you, sir. I'll wait.
Bring them in! Bring everything that you can
make
in!
Make sure you don't leave anything!
Hurry up! Check
off! Hurry!
Jackal!
What?
Aren't we leaving yet?
We will! I'm just making sure that this place is swept clean by the time we leave.
General,
get our men outside over here now!
Yes, General!
Burn everything already!
Good evening, sir. We need to get through. It's an emergency.
I'm sorry, sir. My car broke down. Sir, I really can't get it to move.
Is it all right if I just push your vehicle over to the side?
Of course.
Come on, let's push this thing.
I need to know the name of the person who owns that factory. If you can give me some information, I'd appreciate it. Get back to me quick, okay?
Status?
A roadblock?
We're on our way.
Sir, did anything happen?
I think someone tipped them off. We need to head there. Call for backup.
Yes, sir.
Hello, General. They're on their way.
Hello.
Hello. Have you found found out the traitor that told them about our blasted factory.
Don't worry about it. I'm working on it right now. I'll find out soon.
Hurry up! Get those things out of there!
Move faster!
Hello?
Hello, General. They're almost there.
Can we finally leave?
Let's just make sure. Hey, you, is the place empty? It is? Now go get ready! Did you call our other lookouts?
Already did, General. Close that up!
Make sure to burn all those documents!
Don't leave a single page behind!
Not all of it!
General, they got away.
General, no one else knew of this operation.
Not even our own troops, sir. When we left, that's when they found out where we were headed.
Who's the owner of this property?
Sir, our report's syndicate. It was titled a certain Romina Gonzalez. She's been in the U.S. for years now. Apparently, this property's been long abandoned. The bank could acquire it at any time. They didn't leave any trace, sir.
Ethan? Sir?
It seems we have a spy among our ranks.